Oh, it's always a good day when the biggest tree falls exactly where you want it. That one was actually leaning back towards the little shed up there a little more than I wanted it to be, so. But with the right notch, the right cutting angle, and wedges, and a little bit of smarts, and maybe a little bit of luck, you can get a tree to go where you want it. So, success on that one. And we got a few more there, a few more on this side, and then we'll be ready to start chopping and cleaning. So in the world of tree work, this is called a barber chair, and it's a very dangerous situation to be in for the cutter because you really don't, you have this big chunk behind you that is basically kind of a question mark. You don't know where it's going to go. So I thought this thing was going to fall better. I didn't realize the inside was rotten, and it is. So what I'm going to have to do is shim it up a little bit and then cut from this tree side over here so I can get out of the way. Sharper chain, more fuel, more energy, so I'll be back another day. Fresh chain. Let's get after it. So when it comes to two-cycle stuff that you need mixed gas for, I only run ethanol-free gas mix in my equipment because the carburetors get all gummed up due to ethanol, and it's just so much better. I own I probably own, I don't know, 20 or 25 pieces of steel equipment. And, you know, I can literally run this, put that machine away, put that chainsaw away or whatever, not do anything to it, and it fires right back up a year, 2 years from now. And the reason is that I'm not using ethanol. So, how do you do that? Well, it's difficult because of the fact that ethanol-free gasoline is difficult to find. And so, what you have to do is you have to go to gas stations and you have to find a gas station that sells ethanol-free gasoline. And it's never going to be the cheapest gas. It's only going to be premium. 93 octane usually is what I buy. I buy it, I mark it non-ethanol gasoline, and then either stuff like I would run this in a pony motor on a Caterpillar machine, or I take it and I mix it with two-stroke oil in order to create the ethanol-free mixed gas that I use in all my equipment. So that's what we're going to do here. For a long time, I ran this Opti 2, and I really, really, really liked it. I don't know if it is the cause of a couple chainsaws going bad or not. I kind of wondered. But I used to run a landscape design and construction business, and so we ran this almost exclusively through all of our trimmers, blowers, chainsaws, you name it, hedge trimmers, and never had an issue. So I don't know. I've always wondered, what's your opinion on what type of mixed oil to use? Do you use just the straight orange bottle steel stuff? Do you use Opti 2? I've heard there's like a Red Max. There's a few other brands that I've heard are very good. I'm willing to try anything, but I'd love to know your thoughts, what you use. Anything mixed with ethanol-free gasoline is going to be better than if you has ethanol in it. And so, another thing I usually do is run a little bit higher mix of oil than normal. I'm okay if it smokes a little bit more, but I would prefer to have the additional lubrication. Now, there's a balance. Too much oil is actually very bad. But at the end of the day, having a little bit of extra oil is not necessarily a totally bad thing. It's only bad when you go too far. So we're going to mix up 2.5 gallons. Today we're going to go ahead and use the Steel Ultra. I don't usually use this, but it's all I've got right now. I do have this, but I want to use this up and get rid of it. So we're going to make 2.5 gallons, which is what this jug is. I like this jug because 2.5 gallons is right here. It means I can put that whole thing in there and be good to go. So I always put the oil in first, then you put a little bit of gas, you put the cap on, you shake it, you mix it up, and then you fill it the rest of the way with gas. And the reason for that is to really get that two-stroke oil mixed in with the gasoline. That's probably enough. Now you just fill up the rest of the way. It's not wanting to stay running, so we're gonna, well, that could be the problem. That is a bit clogged, that air filter. Clean this out real quick. All right, that's a bit cleaner. Let's see if that makes a difference. Oh. There we go. Always good practice to warm your chainsaws up. Let them come up to temperature so those rings will seal well and not end up scoring your pistons. Warm up your stuff. Cutting trees and you can't thread the needle, meaning drop one right where there's only one place to drop it, then you shouldn't be dropping trees in those places. Couldn't have been more perfect. It landed in the one spot that it needed to. Heck yeah.
We'll be right back.
All right, so I got a bunch of cleanup done around the back of the building here. That's the burn pile. This is the bigger stuff that's not rotten that a friend of mine is gonna take and burn in a wood burner. At some point, I'm probably gonna move this concrete pad somewhere else. I don't know why it was there. Now, next thing that has to happen is drainage. There was already somebody previous to me that attempted to get it to drain from way over there, all the way through here, on out right there. That green pipe I put there, and then I got another one there, and they're just sitting there. So we got a muddy mess there. Pretty sure there's another spring right here, and then there's another one further up, a couple of them. So this area here needs to drain better. That area needs to drain. That area needs to drain. Some of that will be fixed by grading. Not that spot though. So I'm probably gonna have to dig another trench and pitch the pipe further at an angle and add more rock above it. So we'll see when I get to that. But for now, this is what it looks like. Heck of a lot better cleaned up. You can see the hillside a lot better. So yeah, there's gonna be lots of room for activities back here. And for right now, I've got the International running. That has all of the rotten wood from the dead tree that were full of like black ants, carpenter ants. So all that I stuck in the trailer or in the dump truck, and we're just gonna back it up to the pile and dump it right now. So we're burning off all the junk wood, all the brush, all the hollow, rotten wood that had carpenter ants, all the good wood that's usable for burning. Got in that pile, a friend of mine wants it. That big monster tree that we dropped from way up there is most of the rotten wood there. It was all just junk. So, there's a lot of poison ivy in that, and I'm wearing a mask, trying not to breathe it. I was gonna actually have a bonfire party and have people come out and enjoy the bonfire, but there's too much poison ivy in that, and I don't want anyone getting sick. So, I'm just burning it by myself. All right, so my friend is here and we're gonna get all this wood. Some of it loaded up on his truck and trailer, some of it loaded up on the international service truck, and basically kind of get it out of here. You can hear him, he's cutting a limb up out front, kind of getting that ready to load. But I'm gonna start the wheel loader, probably get the skid steer, get this pallet out of the way. And it's a mucky mess right out here, but so I think what we're gonna do is we're gonna load it and haul it out and load it out front. So let's get right to it.
Whatever easier for you. I don't care. I mean, if you got, let's just get it. Yeah.
Okay. Doesn't matter to me.
I forgot my fuel and oil anyway. So
I've got that.
I don't want to keep it.
It's all good.
Hold another project.
Honestly, I'm happy to have it going.
Yeah.
And really, if you hadn't said you wanted it, it would already be gone. Yep. Glad to see it used.
Yeah, no, it'll be good.
Thank you. I'm gonna dump this.
Okay.
I think we can get it in this one load.
Okay.
If it looks sketchy, we won't.
Thank you.
got it piled high. Yeah, I'd say we're in there pretty good. But I have some ideas.